unless it's a fake. No, Michael Routh is the up back. They are inside the 50-yard line. Here's the fourth down, and they're going to punt it away. Rolling toward the one, and he slides into the end zone. Did he have it down at the one?
I think they're ruling they did.
The ball is spotted inside the one-yard line. How about this call?
I think it's a good call.
So here's the young man, Dick, from Roswell, Georgia, the senior. His last Army-Navy game, he was a high school soccer player until his junior year in Roswell. That's when he started kicking. He has handled all the kicking today for West Point. This, the biggest of his career. A 44-yarder. The ball game riding on it. Perfect. No, hold on. There's a penalty flag. Hold on, penalty flag.
Delay again.
Oh my gosh.
A delay of the game.
That field goal would have been good from 50. I mean, he really nailed it, but wow. It moves now to a
49-yarder. He's got to kick a 49-yarder now.
That 5-yard penalty at an 11% difficulty, more difficult in making the second kick. If you just took the averages in the NCAA kicking.
Make this one and he becomes the chief of staff automatically.
49-yarder.
Malcom hits it again. Holy cow! A 49-yarder. Patmon Malcom, his longest career field goal. And with 12 seconds to go, Coach Sutton has a chance to taste victory. And the reason why, those two men, let's not overlook his holder, Chris Shaw from Mesa, Arizona. It was Chris Shaw who ran in the two-point conversion, setting up the opportunity for a field goal to win this baby. The snapper was J.R. West from North Bend, Oklahoma, and twice he put it on the money. Shaw with the hold and Malcom with the biggest field goal of the last decade for West Point. There's the young man who snapped it. Right on the money.
In a row.
J.R. West. Take a bow, J.R.
Look at me, Ma. I snapped that one.
That's great.
I tell you this, I've been in this stadium at the other end of that kick, Brent. I walked out of here one day, Los Angeles Rammer hit 54 yards with almost no time left in the clock to beat us. So I know the feeling for the other side of the line of scrimmage.
Now there's still 12 seconds left. This is one that they will talk about for the ages between these two rivals.
Talk about a three deep defense, Brad. Look at this one.
First and 15. Ellis going deep, and it is all over. The Chevrolet most valuable players of this classic, Patmon Malcom, who nailed a 49-yarder, and Duke Ingram, who scored 2 touchdowns for Navy in the first half. And Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need. Congratulations to both these great teams and the young men who put forth this effort. For Dick Vermeil and Julie Moran, I'm Brett Musburger. So long, everybody.